Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma test the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die.
Okay, people. So we back. And now it's time to reveal what I got. For real, you know what I'm saying? Like, OMG. All right, I know y'all been waiting because I've been doing this all day. But y'all ain't had to sit here all day because clearly y'all watching this in the video. But I finally made it home, got some more stuff. I got to do another video, but I can't tell you it here. But you're going to watch it. So, let's get right into it, dog. I'm going to do a little breakdown and the takedown. That's what I call these new reviews. So, breakdown and takedown. So, the breakdown. First thing I need to reveal the gun. The weapon. It's a pistol. Heavy pistol. Fuck it. Whatever. It is this big ass bucket. Woo! I hope y'all didn't think I was getting something crazy. Nah, dog. This is definitely... it's a high point. 45. Terrible, right? First of all, it was $100. I mean, let's just get that off the way. Just they wanted 179. But whatever. And they gave a young thug it for 120. So I mean, you couldn't really beat that. They say they reliable. Some people say that they reliable. Let me tell you, it is very heavy. I'm not gonna lie to you. It is heavy by itself, just top heavy. Like very top heavy, and it's very ugly. I'm not gonna lie to you. Comes with one 10 stack magazine. This was used, so I don't know if it came with two or came with one, but this one got one. You put the magazine in it, it looks like that, and it's even heavier. It's like 20 pounds. I don't know, but it has a safety, so there's that, and it racks back like a regular gun. And it locks like a regular gun, huh? Yeah. So, I'm gonna show y'all a little bit more of this firearm. And then we're gonna try to see if we can break it down. They never took it down, but I found out how to do it. So I'm gonna see if that works. We're gonna do a breakdown because it's used and I wanna oil it, clean it, whatever the situation is. So, oh, yeah, let's do that. All right, guys. So here we are, me and I'm in the bathroom because it might get a little messy and then, you know, just whatever. But I have a universal, well, first off, you got to clean the firearm. You want to make sure you have your kit and your gear ready. So they have cleaning gears for just every dang firearm you can just find, well, caliber. So since it's been a 45, I could have bought a 45 cleaning kit, but I didn't want to. I bought a universal cleaning kit because I've already had a 9 and a 45 cleaning kit and I gave them away. Like a dumbass. So, we have a Red Fields Universal Kit. If you want to know where to get that from, I almost said AutoZone. My car channel. I got to update it. This is from Academy, and it was $9.99. You can use it with pistols. On the back, it says 45, 40, 357, 38, 9, and a 22. So you don't have the cleaning pads and everything like that that you would normally have to be able to do that. But tissues, I have personally a terry cloth that I used to wash the Audi with. So there's that. And then, of course, you want to have you some good lube. So I like to use CLP because that's what we use in the Army. Not necessarily this brand, but... it's really great. I love it. It keeps your gun lubricated. It keeps it wet. It keeps it moist. Moist. For a very long time. So, it works. I hope y'all peeped the work shirt. You know what I'm saying? The workflow. You know what I'm saying? Bam! Your boy, the CEO of Walk 'Em Down Safety Systems. You know what I'm saying? No, I don't sell security, goddammit. Or cameras. I teach people how to shoot, get their handgun license, stuff like that. People that have been with me know I can buy y'all. You know what I'm saying? I'll be like, bow! You know what I'm saying? I'll be like, you know what I'm saying? Real quick with it. So bam, you know, peep the threads, baby. ASAP! This is my work shirt. This is not like the gun range shirt. This is the business shirt to talk to other businesses. You know, I'll be like, hi. Hi. How are you doing? I'm Rico. Yes, I love your tie. Yeah, stuff like that. Anyway. Yeah, so ASAP, in case y'all want to know, man, is my, like SWAT. So it's my synonym, acronym, whatever. SWAT stands for Special Weapons and Tactics. ASSP stands for Active Shooting, Active Protection, or Active Planning, or Actual Planning, or Actively Protection. I just don't really know what to do for the end. But that is for my business, where I go to companies, corporations, and things of that nature and teach the owners and employees how to protect their number one asset, which is their employees. Because sadly, in the world we live in today, people like to go shoot up spots and go crazy and everything with active shooting. So, in case you don't know what active shooting is, which I don't know how you wouldn't, the FBI classifies active shooting as the act of an individual, person or persons, actively engaging in the killing of multiple people in a crowded space. That is not word for word, but it's pretty much what it is. But enough of the Debbie Downer stuff. Y'all came for the gun reviews, right? So let's get the gun reviews. All right. That's good. Oh, wait. And then when we take it down, you need a hammer and a takedown pin thing. But I don't think this will work, but we'll figure it out. All right, so here's Ugly Betty, because for right now, that's her name, until I figure out what else to do with this, or call it. Might be Hippopotamus, or Big Bertha. Juicy. Fat ass. Oh, that fat ass. Why do you look so blurry? Oh, okay, let me take this off. It's a new phone. New camera. It's a new camera, not phone. Okay, so dim that down a little bit so y'all can see. All right, so here it is in the flesh. As you can see, it says High Point Firearms Model J whatever P45 ACP, made in Ohio, or whatever the crap it is. Now, it's not like other firearms. You can't just did that pull? We're gonna ignore that, because I haven't actually fired around through here yet, so we'll figure that out. You have a safety on it, so, you know, up is safe. You got the little S that shows you right here. Let me see. See the little S? It shows you that's safe. And then, come on, camera. There you go. And then, down is not safe. You can take these side grips off, the grips, which is cool, because maybe you can get some better grips or some more texture. I'm gonna do something with these, but y'all can see that in a whole different video. So, y'all stay tuned for that. Alright, you feel me? Alright, anyway. So, now we back on here. What else? The trigger is interesting. Maybe that's just there for decoration, whatever. But you guys have a slide rail. I did not see this on the 9. So, maybe put a laser on it or something. Because, let me tell you, put a flashlight on it, you won't be able to carry this damn thing. I tell you that. Just blank at the back. Flip it over. You have your ejector port, of course, where it throws out them giant ass 45 shells, which look, shut up, like this. Yeah, let me see. Boom. You see these things? These the big chunky monkeys. Like this. Let me. That's that. And there's the 9mm. So if you want to do that by scale, let's see. From the top, you can see size doesn't matter. Look at that thing. That is just, that's a hefty round. Hefty, hefty. Yes, it is. So, little brother, big brother, so we got to get the middle brother, huh? Yeah, we'll get one of those. Anyway, who the hell is that? That number's not saved. All right, so, look at that cool guy. Hello there. All right, so anyway, let's put these bullets up and let's get back down to business. I can't do show you the slide lock because it's in my hand, so yeah. Basically, the I don't know what the rattle is, but the I'm missing a rear sight, but it also seems as if it could be changed, which would be interesting if that was the case, because maybe I can get some better sights. And somebody looked like they tried to do something anyway. But the sights, it's not just the worst thing in the world. It looks so weird on camera. Not the worst thing in the world, it's just not the best sights in the world. But, you know, whatever. And that's pretty much all the damn hell is to it. I can tell you, if you never held one, it's like picking up a fully loaded 12-gauge shotgun. Do you hear that? That is premium grade A steel from the industrial age. That shit right there. Yes, it is. So, let's take it off. Let's take it down. We did the breakdown. Actually, though, I didn't tell you how you feel. It actually feels pretty good holding my hand. I'm not going to lie to you. It's a lot longer than I expected. And the magwell in your palms. But it actually is so fat. That's what she said. That it actually feels pretty damn good. It actually feels pretty swell in my hands. I like it. It's good. Still heavy as hell. Sliding it back is not hard, but it's definitely slippery. So make sure your hands are dry or you cut them off. So, cool. Let's get to the takedown. All right, so now we're gonna try to take it down. So first step I heard you have to do is slide the slide back, boom, hit it with the slide lock, which is also the safety. So you pull out of your back, slide it up into that notch, it holds it. You push it down, it releases it. And then it's gonna show a little pin back here. Can y'all guys see it? See that? That's like a little hole right there. That's the pin. You have to push that out. Oh God, I hope I don't break this as soon as I freaking got it. So I'm gonna use this guy, see if it even, it looked like it'll do it. So we gonna see. I just have to watch my facial expression while I do this, because I don't have another way to hold this phone. Woo! Okay. Scared the hell out of me. So, you might want to hold the firearm, because it might slide forward as you try to, you know, take it apart. Scared the hell out of me. But how the hell am I supposed to do this? I only got two damn hands. Well, maybe I'll put them. I got this. I'm a gun guy. Oh, I got it to move, but the gun slid forward. Jesus. It's coming out. Oh, it's coming out. Well, it was coming out. Oh, I see why they're using a piece of wood with a hole in it. Makes a lot more sense. But don't worry, I got this. I got the pin. See, it's coming out. You see it? Hold on. Y'all see it? Look, it's right there. It's coming out. Push it all the way through. The little roller pin gonna look like this. So definitely don't want to lose that because this sink got a giant hole in it. So I'm gonna set it. I'm clumsy as fuck. Where that damn soap dish go? Set it in the soap dish. All right, and then you're supposed to do the slide release to let it go forward. But I recommend you ride it forward, which means using your hand. Goddamn effort. Using your hand to, push forward. I mean, to make sure it don't pop. And then as it comes forward, you're supposed to be able to, push back on it and pull up at the same time. Like that. Push back and pull up. And it should come off. And they say be careful because it's a spring, like the spring load shoot up out of there or something. But now I'm kind of stuck here. It's a hole in this sink and I do not trust it. There we go. So, I'm trying to figure out how the hell has to do this. It needs to be cleaned. I can see that though. Apparently, I did it. Now, getting it back in is going to be crazy. Okay, so quick. As you can see, that's where the spring goes. On most other firearms, it still has a little spot that it goes on. But on most other firearms, is different. So you're gonna wanna put it back in this way and put it back. Yeah. And looks like a World War II gun. Oh, it's gunked up. Look at that slide, man. I mean, look at where the bullet gets seated into the barrel. Very. Is that metal or plastic? It's been fired because there's no, well, there's grooves, barely. But it's, I don't know. Can y'all see this? There's grooves in there, like 007. Might use that. And then you could take the grips off and there's a spring in there that's probably for whatever this is, which I'm not going to touch. Then they say you could take the trigger out some type of way. That might be, I'm not doing nothing yet. This, this is weird. You can shoot somebody with just this. Cool. I don't even know how the trigger works, but hopefully it shoots. Something about a firing pin somewhere. I don't know. We put some rounds in it, take it outside to go shoot. Or we might just shoot like one round today. I just want to see if it shoots. Because I want my goddamn money back if it don't, you know? All right. So anyway, so yeah, we got it taken apart. And now I'm going to clean it. So let's get to cleaning. Guys, I realized I forgot to show y'all the top of the slide. So let me see. As you can see, there's firing pins and stuff and other things you could take out of there and clean if you want to. I personally ain't touching nothing in. I'm just gonna clean the slide. That's a big asshole. And so I see y'all when we done. Alright, you guys, so as you can see, I cleaned. I didn't do nothing outside. But I cleaned. You know, as you can see, it's very shiny. I'm gonna wipe it
obvious stuff up. And I really didn't even soak it. That's just kind of how it does. This is terrifying. I probably leave that cleaning to a professional. For you guys, not for me. I can do it. But that falls off, you screw. Them screws gone, you screw. That's the firing pin that'll come out while you're cleaning it. Very easily screwed. You can see how dirty all that stuff was. This still has a little rattle, but whatever. I cleaned that up a little bit. Cleaned down in the barrel some, you know. And yeah, so let me put this back together, all the rails, and see if I can get it to work. Let me tell y'all something. That motherfucking gun is the hardest goddamn shit to put back together I've ever in my life. It's the most, it ain't hard, it's stressful. It's so goddamn stressful. The little pin that go at the back, listen, it got stuck outside the gun. It's supposed to be in the gun. In the gun! It got stuck outside the gun. So I had to try to redo the gun without sending that pin skyrocketing. Which fell out the back of the gun, teeter-tottered around the sink, and damn near went right into this. Right into that motherfucker right there. Down that deep dark hole. I would have to take apart the whole goddamn sink. That shit right there, y'all. I ain't gonna lie. Don't take that shit apart. I mean, I'll clean it for you, but I'm charging. I'm charging. Do you hear me? I'm charging. You see how it got me looking? Like a goddamn white college frat boy. Ain't got nothing against white college frat boys, but I'm just saying. Anyway, there it is. Cleaned. Insheened. Freaking, you know. Ready for whatever. I ordered it down and stuff and everything. I didn't even do nothing to the top. I'm just, they got attachments and stuff. I'll probably get a laser for it. And, you know, I'm gonna do a color. I'm gonna do a Halloween scheme on it. So, y'all stay tuned for that. I might do that within a day or two. Depends. I just gotta go get the stuff for it. But, I mean, that's my breakdown and takedown. Breakdown on it, 1 out of 10. I'm gonna start rating guns like this. 1 out of 10. 10 being I would recommend. 1 being I would stay away from it. Without shooting, it looked like a Uzi, don't it? Without shooting, I would say probably, honestly, it's heavy as hell. Besides that, I don't think it's such a bad thing. It's ugly. So, but, would I recommend it for the price without shooting it? I'd give it like a 7. The weight, definitely, 1 out of 10, 10 being hell no, it's heavy, 10, especially fully loaded. So like 8 unloaded, 10 loaded. Sex appeal, 0. I'm not gonna lie to you, sexiest. It's sexy less. This is get no cat gun. Or if you're a chick, get no ping type of firearm. But yeah, so that's what I feel about that. But I say it's worth giving it a go. If you need something for protection and potentially reliability, we have to see if it shoots. Which we will. But the takedown, definitely 1 out of 10. 10 being the hardest, I give it like a fucking 4. Taking it apart, like it's not really that hard. Really not even 4, probably like a 3 or a 2. Putting that bitch back together though, let me tell ya, I don't know how long you gotta do that to become a cool smooth dude to do that, but definitely a damn 10. Cause that's stressful as hell. It's not even hard, it's just stressful. Got me in here hot, man. I mean, hot. But either way, that's been the breakdown and the takedown on the High Point OD5. Just got it today, baby. So we will be shooting it, so I'll do a video on that. On how it shoots, you know what I'm saying? Maybe get some attachments for it if they cheap enough. It will be available to shoot if you haven't had a high point and want to see how it feels, or you want to shoot a 45. Also, if you like,
just want to go to the range and shoot it after I customize it or something, I have that available. Other than that, that's pretty much it. I got another video coming to y'all that's gonna be something getting done to the G3, otherwise known as Deadpool, who's sitting in here. Come here, DP. My magazine. Here she. Not a little limp. Here my boy is. That's a. What else I was gonna call that damn man? Hefty. Hugh Hefty. Whew. I'm gonna call it Precious for right now. I'm big as hell. Now, we'll figure out a code name for that can stick to. Fat Cat. I don't know. Whatever. But either way, next video gonna be on the G3 or on shooting that one. I don't freaking know, but it's coming soon. I appreciate y'all for watching. Make sure y'all like and subscribe. If you have any other guns that you want me to review, as long as I can afford them, I shall review them. And if I cannot, maybe I'll go to the gun range, rent them, get them out. Or you can bring your gun out here to the channel, and we can let them go off, and I will review them, and I can do everything else that you guys want me to do. So if y'all got anything y'all want to say, man, come in, holler at your boy. And yeah, I had an exit. What's my damn? Oh yeah, stay easy, be breezy, because yeah.